Today I'll be explaining the Hindu editorial undermining justice. The government must explain the unusual delay in filling up vacancies in courts and tribunals. So the government is delaying or it is making the process of appointing new posts in courts and tribunals, and this is obviously very unusual. It was only a matter of time before the controversy over the union government delaying the judicial appointments hit the headlines again. So the same thing also happened a few months ago, and it is also happening right now. The government, the union government, it is delaying or it is not posting the members in courts and also in tribunals immediately. It is taking a lot of time. It is being very lazy. In recent days, the Supreme Court has voiced concern over the government's lackadaisical attitude towards the large number of vacancies in high courts and tribunals. In the recent days, the Supreme Court has voiced. So, as the union government was being very lazy, they used lackadaisical attitude, means very lazy attitude. So, the Supreme Court was concerned of that attitude and it raised its voice against the union government. And it asked the union government, why are you doing so? Chief Justice of India, N.V. Ramana confronted the government with a list of 240 vacancies in various tribunals. So, the Chief Justice of India, Mr. N.V. Ramana, he confronted the Union government and he asked them boldly, why are you doing this? Why are you delaying so many vacancies? Only in tribunals alone, there are 240 vacancies to which we should still appoint people. He asked rather bluntly whether there was a plan to close down some tribunals. And he straightforwardly asked them that, is there even a plan? Is there even a plan, or do we even have members to appoint? Many tribunals lacking presiding officers and recommendations made by the selection committee have not been acted upon. So they actually they have selected some members to post to appoint in the vacancy, but for some reason the union government haven't appointed them. The vacancies in high courts are at a staggering of 445 as of August 1. The vacancies in tribunals are 240 and in courts they are 445. It appears that exhortations from the courts and even a judicial order from the court fixing time frames for the Intelligence Bureau and the government to process names forwarded by the Collegium for making appointments to the High Courts for returning files and for accepting names reiterated by the judge's body has not imparted a scene of urgency. So it appears that these actions, these exhortations by the court and even a judicial order from the court fixing terms to the Intelligence Bureau to process names. So the Collegium of the High Court, that is the team of the High Court, it has selected a few members and it has passed the names of the few members to the union government. But even though they have passed it, the union government is not taking action. This has not caused a scene of urgency even though the High Court and the Supreme Court have raised their voice, and even if the Supreme Court send the names of the persons to the union government, there is no sign of a sense of urgency in the union government. A two-judge bench has noted that the center's delay in making the appointments to high courts is adversely affecting the education of the commercial disputes, adjudication of the commercial disputes. So because of this delay in appointing people to posts, there has been a serious problem in the commercial disputes. And if we don't resolve this problem, our economy may be even hit more by the COVID-19. The judiciary's concern over the vacancies in the tribunals is quite justified, as the jurisdiction previously exercised by high courts is now being exercised by the tribunals, and the failure to adjudicate or dispose the disputes in these fields would amount to denial of justice to the parties. So why the Chief Justice N.V. Ramana, Mr. N.V. Ramana, was so concerned about this delay by the union government is very clear. Obviously they must be concerned, because As we just read in the last sentence, if this problem doesn't get solved, we'll be having some serious problems in commercial disputes. And also, if the union government, if it doesn't resolve the problem, it may not be causing justice for various parties. The present regime's eagerness to undermine the independent functioning of the tribunals is quite apparent. So the author is saying that the present system's eagerness, its keenness, or its willingness to undermine, to weaken the independent functioning of tribunals is quite apparent. So author is saying that basically the government wants to weaken the independent functioning of the tribunals. It has been repeatedly forming rules that seek to provide for greater executive control over the tenure, emoluments, conditions of the service of those manning the tribunals. So recently, the government has been taking many steps to make the situation better in tribunals and courts, but it is not acting right now. If specialization, domain expertise, and relatively quicker adjudication are the reasons for which certain kinds of disputes are being resolved through tribunals, these purposes are lost if these bodies are rendered nearly dysfunctional to a large number of vacancies. To compound the problem, the union government has been inexplicably reluctant to create a national body for overseeing the work which is related to the appointment of the members on tribunals as well as the appraisal of their functioning. So to compound the problem of the union government delaying appointing people to certain posts, it is also not forming a body to choose the members and to help the union government place the members or to appoint the members in their posts. So if we even start right now, it's going to take a long time because even a body to appoint the members isn't formed. As far as higher judiciary appointments are concerned, there is little to enlighten the public on what is causing today and causing the delay. The courts and the judiciaries are saying that, I mean, it's okay if the union government is delaying appointing people to their posts in courts and tribunals. It should at least say us what the reason is. It should enlighten us. It should tell us why the reason of the delay. Whether it is a dispute over the undoubtedly problematic memorandum of the procedure or the desire of the executive to subject the collegium recommendations to its own political scrutiny is not clear. So whether it is a problem in hiring, in forming a body to appoint the people to their posts in courts and tribunals, or is it some other thing like the desire of executive subject the collegium recommendations? In any case, the delay is causing great harm to India's justice delivery system. So whatever the reason may be, even if there is a dispute in the procedure, or even if there is a problem in the procedure, or even if it is something, anything else, this delay is severely causing harm to the India's justice delivery system, because if there are not enough officials in the courts, 455 officials are missing. So that's a very big concern. So obviously it is harming India's justice delivery. We need to fix this as soon as possible. Thank you.